sa ating mga trabahador, our employment rate has increased to 95.9%. We also saw a significant increase in high-quality jobs. Underemployment, too, has decreased from 11.7% in May of 2023 to 9.9% today. This is our lowest number since 2005. Notably, we also saw an increase in middle-skilled employment, wage and salaried employment, and full-time jobs. Magagandang balita pa rin ang mga ito sa kabila ng nararanasang mataas na presyo ng pagkain. Bukod sa paglikha ng trabaho, pinalalakas din natin ang kakayahan ng ating mga mamamayan, lalo na sa panahon ng kanilang kagipitan. Our adaptive and responsive social protection programs assist our countrymen in times of dire need, reaching those in geographically isolated and disadvantaged areas. More importantly, these programs seek to develop their productive potential and bridge their capacities towards self-sufficiency. With a noble aim of breaking the cycle of poverty across the country, the Pantawid Pamilya Program, the Pantawid Pamilyang Pilipino Program has not only consistently accomplished its annual targets, it has also proven its efficacy over the years. Mula nung nakaraang SONA, mahigit 420,000 pamilya ang nag-graduate sa programa. Ibig sabihin, sa tulong ng 4Ps, mas gumanda na ang kanilang kalagayan at kakayahang makipagsapalaran sa laban ng buhay. Sa katunayan, mahigit 4,000 graduate ng 4Ps ay nasa hanay na ngayon ng mga lisensyadong guro. At hindi lamang yun. 35 sa mga top-notcher ng sari-saring mga board exam na idinaos nitong nakalipas na 2 taon ay nagmula sa mga pamilya na benepisyaryo ng 4Ps. Ilan sa kanila ay si Teacher Kane Jevy Cervantes ng Davao Oriental na nakakuha ng number 1 sa licensure examination for professional teachers. Isa rin si Engineer Alexis Aligado na nanguna sa Civil Engineering Board Exam noong Abril ng nakalipas na taon. Tomorrow, the birth date of Apolinario Mabini, we cap off the National Disability Rights Week. Our PWDs can rest assured of government's effective implementation of beneficial policies and programs that will guarantee equitable opportunities, special interventions, and incentives for them. Mula nang pumasok ang administrasyong ito, nagsimula na ang mga programang pangkabuhayan na nakalaan para sa ating mga PWD. Sa susunod na taon, ilulunsad naman ng PhilHealth ang benepisyo nito para sa mga batang may kapansanan. Halos dinoble na rin ang diskwento na ibinibigay sa mga PWD at sa mga senior citizen na tulad ninyo para sa mga basic necessities at prime commodities. Natuwa kayong lahat nun. Sa lahat ng mga ginagawa natin ito, katuwang natin palagi ang pribadong sektor, lalo na sa mahalagang bagay ng trabaho at pasahod. With tripartite consensus, minimum wage levels have been increased in various sectors in all regions, including the BARM, for workers and private establishments. Makakapagdulot ito ng ginhawa sa mahigit 4,000,000 mga kababayan na natin at ng kanilang mga pamilya. Para naman sa ating mga kawani ng gobyerno, mayroon silang maaasahang medical allowance bilang karagdagang benepisyo sa susunod na taon. At hindi lamang iyon, mayroon ding napipintong aumento sa sweldo na makukuha nila sa 4 na tranche Naglaan na po tayo ng pondo para dito simula sa taong ito at sa mga susunod na taon. Furthermore, we have extended the services of our job order and contract of service personnel working in government. This will also afford them ample opportunity to work on their civil service eligibilities while gaining additional relevant experience and training to upgrade their employment qualifications. Our aggressive infrastructure development, business-friendly policies, investment and export promotions, foreign visits, and economic missions are all aimed at generating not just jobs, but quality and competitive jobs. A substantial number of investment pledges have already commenced operations, with many more at various stages of development. Sa bilang natin, bukod sa malalaking kita para sa bansa, makakalikha ang mga ito ng mahigit 200,000 trabaho para sa ating mga kababayan. The rationalized incentive scheme under the CREATE Act has also made possible the generation of investments amounting to more than 1 trillion pesos and more than 100,000 new jobs. This promising state of affairs is now beckoning us to create more through the passage of the Create More Act. Conscious efforts to improve the ease of doing business and delivering government services through our digitalization, integration, and streamlining of processes have produced their intended multiplier effects. Cost savings from operations have translated to higher revenues and to more speedy transactions. These have effectively addressed the fragmented, overlapping, and time-consuming procedures that have hindered optimal productivity by government. Attributable to these transformative reforms, government services are becoming more efficient. More and more systems are now digital and cashless, assimilating individuals, MSMEs, even agricultural workers. These have expedited transactions and commercial exchanges and promoted the convenience of all parties concerned. Ang Paling QR ay isa sa mga programang unti-unting lumalakas, ang hatak sa publiko at dumarami ang gumagamit. Bolstering our Cybercrime Prevention Act, the recently passed Anti-Financial Account Scamming Act will further protect the public by heightening the responsibility of and security systems of banks and financial institutions and imposing high criminal liabilities on social engineering schemes and money mules. Job placement also has seen significant progress, especially through our public employment service offices, or PESOS, nationwide. PESOS have harnessed IT capabilities and improved labor-industry coordination. Collectively, they boast a job placement success rate of 98%. Likewise, due to shortened timelines, we have recorded a significant increase in new business and corporate registrations, including foreign firms, which surpassed last year's numbers. The observed choke points in our food supply chains and in the logistics sectors are now being removed. And at the same time, the identified gaps are being filled in to make them efficient, interconnected, and seamless, saving precious time and cost. The approval of energy projects is moving towards complete virtual integration of its required procedures. The expedited processing of our infrastructure flagship projects under the Build Better More program shall also follow suit. Our digital infrastructure was substantially strengthened courtesy of common towers that more than tripled in number since last year, owing to streamlining of permitting requirements. Air transport and tourism have been made more convenient because of the shift to paperless immigration and customs forms, thanks to the e-travel system. And soon, the piloted e-gates will be standard fixtures at airports to further facilitate ease of mobility during departures and arrivals. And with all this said, the implementation of the Philippine e-visa will be next in our digital transformation agenda. Let us now go to tourism. Because we in the Philippines have no less than 7,641 beautiful reasons to tap the potential of our tourism sector, for which our archipelagic nation is internationally renowned and from which many Filipinos derive their livelihood. While a resurgence in this all-important sector is being observed, pre-pandemic data present to us a great challenge that we must surpass. It is a challenge that is well within our grasp. Our infrastructure and digital reforms to development of tourism sites and the enhancement of the overall tourist experience are all calculated to boost the productivity of the tourism sector. While doing so, we shall interpose the wholesome and hospitable Filipino brand in all the key tourism touchpoints, from tourist arrival all the way to departure. But the tourism challenge has already evolved and now requires a multifaceted strategy. The focus now is on experiential tourism. Food, culture, heritage, the arts, education, halal, Islamic traditions, dive, cruise, farm and ecotourism, even sports, have now become potent subjects and products of a nation's tourism. This is an imperative, and that we must elevate and expand our understanding of the one town, one product, or OTOP concept. It must not inhibit, but rather it must inspire. We must not rest content to have just one. Rather, we must seek the optimal number of high-quality products and services which at the same time showcase our community's distinctive history, traditions, and talents. Filipino creativity and ingenuity will enliven and unlock the as-yet untapped potential of these new facets of Philippine tourism. Sa ating mga OFW, ayon sa datos ng Bangko Sentral, mahigit 37 bilyong dolyar ang naipasok sa bansa ng ating mga OFW noong nakalipas na taon. Sadyang napakalaking tulong nito sa ating bumabangon na ekonomiya. Kaya hindi lamang pasasalamat, kundi parangal ang ating ipinapaabot sa lahat ng ating mga OFW.